My name's Kris Tyler. I'm a cancer survivor. I found out I had cancer about 2 years ago. I had problems swallowing, you know, so basically I went to the doctors because I've had acid reflux for basically ever. But this actually felt a lot different than that. You know, I had a different spot and just different feelings. So we finally went to the doctors and basically they told us, you know, they're going to scope it out to see what it was. So had it scoped out and came back and the doctor said it was cancer, you know. I mean, it was scary to begin with, you know, but the doctors that I went to were basically reassuring, and they were the best doctors that I know to go to for everything, every step of the way. You know, the doctor I went for the ultrasound and all everything else. So I've had four or five different doctors, and you know, each doctor sent me to another doctor who was the specialist in their field. Went over to Moffitt, you know, had the cancer removed. Thank God I was ignorant to the fact, you know, they told me I was going to be in the hospital for about 10 days in intensive care. Basically, you know, they said they was going to go inside and cut out a little spot for my esophagus because I had esophageal cancer. You know, so they cut out a little spot and put it back together. But before that, I had the chemo and radiation. You know, that to begin with, the chemo wasn't that bad. But after a couple weeks, it really started messing with my emotions. You know, I got real tired and cranky and irritable. And, you know, my family and those around me kind of suffered for it. And, you know, I feel really bad about that. After the cancer, you know, things have slowly, not perfectly, but slowly got back on track. You know, I can at least get out of bed and, you know, do things. Probably about 50% of what I used to be. And, you know, I'm really glad that I survived it. I mean, it didn't take a humongous emotional toll on me because I trusted, you know, trusted in the Lord, and I gave it all up to the doctors and to God because, well, what else can I do, you know? I was just a passenger in a car, you know? All the other doctors were driving, you know, and the experience was definitely tough, you know. I can imagine, you know, going through it before I went through it, and everything that my family went through, I appreciate the support and love that they've given me. And, you know, to this day I still have effects of it, you know. You know, even just from the operation, you know, I've got a messed up hand and, you know, half my side's numb. You know, it's just a side effect from the operation, but I'm glad I got rid of the cancer, and, you know, I plan on living a long, long time. I was scared one time, you know, when I was listening to a friend of mine saying that, you know, they had a friend that died of cancer, that, to me, that was probably the most emotional part of the whole thing. I broke down, actually. But other than that, you know, it's, you know, for me, like I said, you know, I was just a passenger in the car. I had my seatbelt on, it's holding tight. So I've been cancer-free since February 2011, and it's a big relief, and I'm so happy. Dreams, that's where I have to go. We both admit we had it good, but until then it's alienation. I know that much is understood, and I realize if you ask me.